You're tuned into a special episode of The Occidental Tourist. I'm Wesley Holzer.
And I'm Shirley Lin.
Today we're at one of Taipei's most important and noticeable landmarks, the Presidential Office. And we're going to say hi to our tour guide today, Mr. Ron Chen.
Hi.
Hi, thank you. Mr. Chen, thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome.
Can we talk a little bit about what we're going to see today?
Yes, you're welcome to visit the Presidential Office. I think today we are from four aspects. One is the architectural beauty. The second is about the Governor General story. And the third one is about the Presidential story. And last one is talking about this beautiful island, Formosa, Taiwan.
All right,
welcome
you
today.
Good.
Okay. Yes. Thank you.
Here's the main passage. I think the, according to protocol, the main entrance is only allowed the president and the vice president.
Oh.
And he's the distinguished guest. So now we are just feeling the experience of watching this main passage.
Well, really honored then.
Yeah.
Yes. I see that there's also this this chair for people with disabilities.
Yes, for the unable person.
That's very considerate.
Yes, right.
Well, this is very beautiful.
Yeah. It's grand. It's so white.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we ask what this room is?
Yes, we are here now. It's an entrance hall. I would like to introduce this entrance hall. It's a combined with the refined architectural construction and with the artist's creation. Mm-hmm. So the arc ceiling, the arc of the window, to make this more grandiose. I think this height is 16.5 meters high. Mm. So we are now here, it's the second floor.
Oh, okay.
Yes, yeah, so we have to climb to the step. So here is a second floor. I think all the columns, it's a post-Renaissance architecture, like the broken gable, that one. And also those 2 meters column to make this construction very dedicated and refined.
So do guests usually come in through here and walk up these steps?
Yes.
Yes.
I think only the
very important
and vice president and the very important person.
Right.
And that's the point. After the guest visiting our president and vice president, we take the photo here.
Ah. With the statue of Sun Yat-sen in back.
National founder.
Right.
Father.
Okay.
Oh, so today we're very important people.
Yes.
Thank
yes.
you.
Wow, we get to take these stairs.
Oh wow, I definitely recognize this room.
Yeah?
And you can see that even the rooftop is really ornate, the ceiling rather, is really ornate. Between the lights there, they've got these tiny little tiles.
Yeah, I think we are now here, it's an auditorium.
Uh-huh.
I think this space allowed accommodate more than 400%. That's
400.
A very important meeting venue for the national top political leader here. And also this major activity hold on here, like the Presidential inside the concert, the banquet, a state banquet, and the dinner party, tea party, etc.
Oh, they're all taking place here?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
So this is almost like the heart of the presidential office right here. This is a very important room.
Yes.
Wow, I feel underdressed for the occasion. I should be wearing a tie.
We're under the spotlight right now. Wow.
I think we look at the arc ceiling and also the arc skylight around this auditorium. This from the middle, from the S-bulb to the ceiling, it's 8 meters high. And also the two-tone. To turn it's the bat. So bat and arc, it's a pronunciation in Chinese, it's also it's a bracing.
Well, I know the bat is Fu, which is like,
yes,
which is like
yes,
a blessing. What about arc? What's arc in Chinese?
It's gong. Gong, Fu. Also have a Fu.
Right.
So the number 8 is a good number.
Right.
Like the Hong Kongese, 168.
It's a good number.
Yes. Sitting nine. And also the thousand about the word lamp. It's like to indicate our country to the any kind of direction.
I see that there's a portrait of Dr. Sun Yat-sen.
Yes, right.
With many rooms in the presidential office, I think.
So, wow, this is a very nice portrait. Wow, so there's just a lot of auspicious meanings to this room here. You know, everything's the number 8. And
12? Red carpet. Red is a very auspicious color.
I think the old construction with the arc, ceiling, arc, skylight, to make this construction very refined and clear and also very comfortable, eco-effective. So we are listening, the sound is very nice, very comfortable, right? Without the speaker out.
I do feel the echo.
It's very surreal that the spot we're standing on right now
is
where President Ma Ying-jeou stood on just about a year ago. Just a couple months ago when he took the oath of inauguration, gave a little address.
Yeah.
It's very, I don't know, I feel presidential. It's very cool.
I'm the first lady.
You're the first lady. When you hold on the microphone to deliver your address, your speech, then something like you are in inauguration speech.
I can imagine rows and rows of people with their eyes just set on you.
All right. Wow, I feel so important. Mr. President, I'm just kidding.
Yes, we're the guests here, I guess, and Ron is the president.
That's right,
The room is, we call it a rainbow room. The rainbow room is the meaning, it symbolizes for the internal and the magnificent honor from the heaven. The rainbow, it the means, it's the 7 colors. It's to across the bridge to both sides, the peace. And also Taiwan was a close relationship with the international and the interaction and exchange with the international.
Wow. How many chairs are there right now? Or actually, how many people can fit in here?
I think here is a small press conference. So it depends on how many report here.
Okay.
Also a small reception room.
So you're saying that these chairs don't necessarily are formed in this way, like an oval shape? It could have been like in rows or whatever. I see.
Well, I'm curious about all these paintings. We see there are paintings from all over Taiwan.
Yeah.
Anyone want to take a guess what this mountain might be?
What?
You know what the mountain is.
This one?
I have a guess or two.
You do?
Yes.
There's snow on it.
Well, yeah, so it could be Snow Mountain because there's snow on it. But I think it's probably the tallest mountain in Taiwan.
Yes, the tallest mountain in Taiwan.
Which would be the Jade Mountain.
Yes, correct. The Jade Mountain.
Oh, wow. This is a big, big portrait.
This room is like a trip around Taiwan in portraits.
Oh, yeah. Taipei 101 over there.
Hey, I have an idea. I'm going to bring you to another attracting and exciting room for you.
All right.
Lisa?
Yeah.
And
so, let's go.
Go. We are here.
Oh, wow. This is fast. Going through a time machine.
Yes.
Wow. So I didn't expect that the presidential office, the most important building in the Republic of China, would have a museum attached to it.
I know.
Yes. I think a lot of the exhibition room we are open to the public,
right.
So you are welcome every morning, in the weekend. Also, the special day for open to the public is every Saturday, every month. So you are more than welcome.
Wow!
I'll definitely be coming back.
Yeah, there's not only just a museum. There's also the gift shop. Obviously, you have to, you know, think that the public, when they come, they want to be able to buy something to go bring back with them.
Yes.
So I never thought that part of presidential building is actually the museum itself.
Yes. As you mentioned, inside also we have a souvenir shop. So they are put on some very special gift and souvenir. So later on, you can take a look, feel around to buy someone.
All right, I think we should.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely. What I see here is a portrait of the presidential office behind us.
Yes, we just stand in front of our presidential office. We get a much feeling about that. It's very imposing and gorgeous, right?
Right. You can even see the armed guards out in the front.
Yes. This is a beautiful presidential office, right?
Right, right.
And also, it's through the second ward, bombing. Oh, it's the other things, the post on the other side.
Oh, yeah, right. That's right. Yeah.
So the building was bombed by who?
By American Air Force.
Allied powers.
Right. Because at that time, Taiwan belonged to the Japanese.
Japan, right.
Then the American is fighting with Japan.
So
then
the
our people, Taiwanese, is suffer this disaster. Yeah.
So when they bombed the building, were they aiming for the governor general?
Yes.
Oh, I see. They're going for the political center of Japan occupied Taiwan.
Yes, right.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Chen, for showing us the whole place. This is really a great experience for us. We don't often come to presidential building itself, right?
So thank you so much. Well, that's it for today's program. Thanks for joining us. I'm Wesley Holzer.
And I'm Shirley Lin.
Off we go.